So you're a writer. What brings you here?
So someone told me that you can tell me a story that will make me believe in God.
It's a long story. Do you want to sit down?
Yeah, sure.
So, you want a story that will make you believe in God?
Well,
it started when I was a child. I grew up in a zoo in Pondicherry, India. I grew up around a lot of animals, but the animal that was most important to me was a Bengal tiger named Richard Parker. I remember the first time I met Richard Parker. He was new to the zoo, and I really wanted to see what he looked like.
You know what you've been doing?
I've seen the zookeeper do this 1,000 times. I just want to see Richard Parker.
What are you doing?
It was a peaceful childhood. But when I was 16, my father decided to move to Canada.
This lamb is exquisite.
Sorry, going to Mecca, Swami Jesus?
You know, he has a point. He can't believe in three religions at once.
Pi is just finding his way.
I'd rather you have faith in reason than faith in religion.
The primary characters of the film are Pi Patel, the initiate who experiences the hero's journey, Richard Parker, a tiger who becomes a close companion to Pi Patel, the writer who makes Pi recount his life story, and Santosh Patel, Pi's father who has a close relationship with his son despite not agreeing with Pi's religious beliefs.
Boy, I sure am happy that I live in India with my zoo and my girlfriend.
About that.
Unfortunately, sons, we're gonna have to move to Canada. Our animals will be worth much more there, and I have some opportunities that will be very beneficial for our family.
The known world in this journey is Pi growing up with his father's animals at the zoo and living in India with his mother, father, and brother.
Babe, I love you so much.
I love you too, but I have something to tell you.
What?
I'm going to Canada.
Really, Pi? Are you gonna go to Canada?
I'm sorry, but my entire family's going. I have to go.
Okay.
Pi's girlfriend is the threshold guardian. She tries to stop Pi from going to Canada and asks to make sure that he is ready. She eventually steps aside with silence and lets Pi continue on his journey.
Bye.
Bye, Pi.
The call begins when Pi's parents announce that they will be moving to Canada because there will be better financial opportunities for the family. They travel via ship, and Pi is forced to completely abandon his known world of India.
After a few uneasy days on the ship, I woke up to a huge storm. I don't remember what woke me up. I think it was some thunder or maybe some lightning, but I woke up. I went up to the deck to investigate, and I saw these huge waves, and they were sweeping people overboard, and I got really scared, so I went back inside. But it was starting to flood. So when I looked at the boat a few days later, I reviewed what I found. I was stranded on a boat with a hyena, an orangutan, and an injured zebra.
No! Zebra, no! Hyena!
We're okay, Orange Juice.
Orange Juice, no! Orange Juice! Hey! Come on! Come on!
The threshold is when a sudden storm strikes Pi's ship. Pi becomes separated from his family, and all he is left with are some of the trained zoo animals. Pi is now fully thrust into the unknown world.
Provides Pi a sense of hope during his dangerous journey. God aids him by giving him the motivation he needs to survive the long treacherous journey ahead by providing him a promise of survival.
In his abyss, Pi loses all hope for survival. He believes that he has lost everything, from his journal to his family. He looks to the sky during a giant storm and wonders why God had forsaken him. Pi reaches his lowest point and loses his hope.
Why, God?
You're dying, Richard Parker.
Pi's mentor would be Richard Parker, because he gives Pi's life meaning after he had just lost everything he had held dear. Pi's helpers consist of the Survival Handbook, which teaches Pi how to survive while stranded in the middle of the ocean, and gives Pi an outlet to express and document his thoughts and feelings, and Orange Juice, who provides Pi a sense of companionship before his death.
The revelation occurs when Pi comforts an unwell Richard Parker after a huge storm. Pi realizes that he cares for Richard Parker and that they both needed each other throughout the journey. Pi also realizes that God was accompanying him along the journey, allowing him to survive for as long as he did.
That was the last big storm I was in when I was at sea. Sometime after that, I fell upon the shores of Mexico, where a group of people found me and carried me to a hospital. I never saw Richard Parker again.
After Pi experiences his revelation, his faith in God is fully restored, and he's not only concerned about his own survival, but the survival of Richard Parker as well. Pi's view on religion and his relationship with Richard Parker are now fully realized.
While I was recovering in the hospital, two Japanese investigators who were part of the shipping company in charge of the ship that sank, they came over to hear my story and try to find a reason for why the ship sank. They didn't believe my story.
Wait, so let me get this straight. You were stranded on a boat with a tiger?
Yeah, that's exactly what I'm telling you.
We're not here to talk about meerkats, tigers, and whatnot. We're here to talk about why the ship sank.
No, that's the actual story.
We just need a story that we can take back to our bosses without looking like idiots.
So you want the real story? Without tigers, without meerkats, without a carnivorous island?
Yes, the truth.
The real story? There were three other survivors. The cook, a sailor, my mother, and I. The cook was a ruthless man. The poor sailor, when he fell from the lifeboat, he broke his leg, and it got really infected. And when the cook saw this, he didn't hesitate to cut it off. the sailor was in such pain. He later died. We later saw the cook using the sailor's leg for bait and sometimes even meat. My mother kept telling him, you monster, but the cook didn't care. He just wanted food. He just wanted to be comfortable. Later, we saw him using the sailor's body for meat again. It was rotting. He didn't hesitate to just use it as bait. We caught many fish that way, but still, my mother didn't eat any of it. One time, my mother and the cook fought a lot of times. One time, I dropped a turtle. I was so tired. I was so hungry. I just dropped it. The cook immediately hit me. My mom said, "Go to the raft." I would never have gone if I knew what was gonna happen. The next thing I knew, her body was being dropped overboard. I stayed in the raft that whole day. The next morning, I killed him. The cook left the knife out. He didn't even try. He knew he'd gone too far, even by his own standards. So I spent the rest of the journey alone, in a large, vast ocean, until I came to the coast of Mexico.
When Pi returns to civilization, he shares the events that unfolded while he was stranded with Richard Parker. However, nobody believes him because it sounds too absurd to be true. Pi then decides to create a fabricated story that still goes along the lines of the true story, but people replace the roles of the animals on the raft. Pi uses his mother to represent the orangutan, the cook to represent the hyena, the sailor to represent the zebra, and he represents Richard Parker. Pi leaves it up to the people to decide which story is true and which one is false. Pi returns with a new vision of himself and with the gift of wisdom.
So which story is true then?
Whichever one you choose.
So I think I prefer the one with the tiger.
So may I write your story?
Yes, of course. It's yours now.
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Pi is gifted with the story to tell others, a story of friendship and survival that would make one believe in God, a story which he then gives to the writer to pass on to others throughout the world.